I'm Bobby Sanabria. Bienvenido. Mi nombre es Bobby Sanabria, and welcome to Fundamento Volume 1. If you work with conga basics, you already have some of the fundamental techniques down about playing the instrument that today we call the conga drum. Si has comprado conga basics video, ya conoces un poco de la técnica sobre tocando ese instrumento que hoy llamamos conga. But in Fundamento Volume 1, we're going to go into more in-depth study of this instrument. The conga drum as we know it today has a long, rich history. Now a lot of people think this drum comes directly from the Caribbean, but not so. Actually, its birthplace is the west coast of Africa in a country called Zaire. There, a tribe of people known as Bantu developed a drum that was very, very similar to this drum. It's the grandfather of the modern day conga drum. Now the Bantu people were brought over to the Caribbean in the 16th century. In 1511, Africans began to be brought to the Caribbean, specifically to the Dominican Republic first by the Spaniards, who needed them to cultivate the land. Unfortunately, they made them slaves. By 1513, black slavery extended all throughout the Caribbean, the islands like Puerto Rico, where my roots are from, and of course, the largest island of the Caribbean, Cuba. There, many rich African traditions have still survived. The two main groups of Africans that were brought over were the Yoruba people from Nigeria and the Bantu from Zaire. And this is their drum, the conga. Now the conga has been used relatively only a short time as far as dance music is concerned. In Cuba, the drum was only relegated to playing in the carnival music, what we call the conga de comparsas of Santiago, Cuba in the eastern part, and in Havana, Afro-religious music. Many different African religions were brought over to the Caribbean. For example, Santeria, which we know as Lukumi also, which is of Yoruba tradition, and Palo, which is from Zaire, from the Bantu. And this drum is used in both traditions. And also the Rumba tradition, which we're going to talk about in a little while later on in the video, where drumming, voices and dance play an integral part. That was a music that was born in Havana in the 19th century and also on the docks of Matanzas, Cuba, a city right next to Havana. Today, the conga drum is used in all forms of music, from pop music to rock music and, of course, Afro-Cuban music. This drum started to be used in dance orchestras in the 1930s. One of the people that helped to make this drum an acceptable part of the dance orchestras was the great blind Cuban guitarist, Mr. Arsenio Rodriguez. He played a typical folkloric instrument from Cuba known as the tres. It's a mandolin-sounding instrument that has three sets of two strings or three sets of three strings. But Arsenio's background is Bantu Congolese, and he also was a great drummer. And in his Cuban group, which is what we call a conjunto, a small band with two trumpets, the tres, piano, bass, bongo, and the conga, okay? He utilized the conga, he added it to his group as a permanent fixture, okay? And this drum, ever since the 1930s, has been used in dance bands. Now, the drum has, the drums come in different sizes, right? We have a small drum known as the requinto. It's rarely used. It's used for the carnival music in comparsa, okay? The conga de comparsa, it's a solo drum. It's very high pitch. It's very, very small. Not many people use it in the band context. Then we have the quinto drum, which is a solo instrument in the rumba tradition. Both the requinto and the quinto get their names from Spanish guitars. There is a guitar called requinto, and there is another guitar called quinto. Then we have the middle drum, which is known commonly as conga. That drum has many names. It can be called segunda, segundo, seguidora, seguidor, llamador, llamadora, tres golpes, tres dos, tres. Many names for just one drum. Okay, the conga is also the most versatile drum because it can be tuned high and it can be tuned low. Then we have the lowest drum, which is known as tumbadora. It can also be called salidor or tumba. Okay? And so we have the requinto, we have the quinto, and just to repass, the quinto can also be known as primo. It's a very rare name for that drum, but some people still use it in Cuba, primo. We have the conga with all its different names, and the tumbadora. If you meet somebody from Eastern Cuba, they call the drums in general jicamo, jicamo. And most Cubans just call the drum in general tumbadora. Here in the United States, we know it mostly as conga. So this drum has a long, rich history, and it's our direct tie to Africa in the Caribbean. If you have conga basics, you already know about the proper playing position and four basic strokes that you need to play repetitive rhythms, tumbaos. Si ya tienes conga basics, ya conoces la posición, como uno se sienta, como uno aguanta el tambor, y cuatro movimientos de la mano para reproducir tumbaos, ritmo que se repite. We're going to review that, and I'm going to give you two more strokes that you need to know to play more advanced tumbaos. Vamos a repasar eso y voy a donar dos movimientos más. The first sound is the heel sound. El primer sonido es el talón de la mano. You can do it with your right hand also. Lo puedes hacer con la mano derecha, obviamente. The next sound is the tip of the fingers. La punta de los dedos. Obviamente lo tiene que hacer con la mano izquierda. The next sound is probably the most difficult sound to get out of the conga drum, and everybody has problems with it in the beginning when they begin to play. El próximo sonido es el sonido más difícil de sacar de la tumbadora de la conga. Todo el mundo cuando empieza tiene problemas con este sonido. That sound is what we call golpe seco, dry attack, or slap in English. Ese sonido se llama golpe seco en español. Okay, to get it, you're going to form your hand in the shape of a cup, like if you were taking water out of a bucket or a pail. Your thumb is touching your first finger and slightly pointing outward. Okay? Piensa que está formando la mano en la forma de una copa para sacar agua de una batea, de una paila. Así. Este dedo grande está tocando el primer dedo, el dedo que indica. Okay? Now, this hand, esta mano, will strike the drum in this fashion. And when you strike, okay, your hand should still be in the form of a cup. Cuando atacas el tambor, la mano debe estar en la posición de una copa todavía. Okay? It's almost like you're squeezing the drum. You're pressing on the drum. Es como si estuviera apretando el tambor, así. Okay? Notice the position. Nota la posición. Now, to help to get this dry attack, you're going to put this left hand right here on the drum, and notice how the wrist breaks a little bit because of the angle of the drum. Vas a poner esta mano encima del tambor para ayudar a sacar el golpe seco. Nota que la muñeca aquí está doblada aquí un poquito, está doblado aquí, perdón, un poquito, por el ángulo del tambor. Okay, remember the cup. Recuérdense de la copa. You still have the shape of a cup. Todavía tienes la forma de una copa. Okay? Recuerda la forma de la mano como tratando de sacar agua de una batea, de una paila. Remember, it's like you're taking water out of a bucket. That shape. Okay? Let's do it with the left hand. This hand over here. Okay? Now, you can get this same slap sound without the dry effect, like this. Puedes hacer el mismo, sacar el mismo sonido, pero sin ese sentido de que está seco, bien seco. Un sentido más abierto. Okay? We use this sound, obviously, when we're doing combination soloing. Obviamente estamos usando este sonido cuando estamos haciendo combinaciones, haciendo improvisaciones, etc. Okay? That's the slap sound. Ese es el golpe seco. Cuando el golpe está abierto, no seco, mucha gente llama ese golpe galleta. Okay? Galleta. Okay? So, many people call this golpe seco when it's not muffled like this, an open slap. An open slap. Okay? Now, we have the open tone, which is relatively easy to get. Tenemos el golpe abierto. You form an L with your hand. Forma una L con la mano. Open like this, the fingers together. Los dedos así juntos. And let the fingers bounce off. But as you can see, this part of the hand stays down on the rim of the drum. Los dedos van para arriba así, y esta parte de la mano se queda aquí. Okay? Ese es el sonido abierto, el golpe abierto, el tono abierto, the open tone. Do it with your left hand, obviously. Okay? It's a relatively easy sound to get. Now, we're going to do two more sounds now. Vamos a adornar dos más movimientos. This sound is using your palm to get the bottom sound out of the drum, like what we would call a bass tone. Este sonido es con la palma de las manos. Vamos a sacar un tono bajo del tambor. Listen to how it sounds. If I lift the drum, you notice how powerful it sounds, that bass tone. Si levanto el tambor, nota que el sonido es bien fuerte. And of course we do it with the left hand. Okay. Now, the last sound I'm going to show you is what we call in Spanish tapao. Tapao literally means to close off something. To close off, in this case, the sound of the drum. Este movimiento se llama tapao. Vamos a cerrar el sonido del tambor. Le da al tambor una calidad humana. Una cualidad humana. We're going to give this, the drum more of a human quality. You know, your voice has different sounds, so the drum has different sounds. We're going to muff the tone, muffle the tone. So to do that tapao, we put our fingers flat on the drum. This sound is used a lot in the rumba tradition when the drummers improvise, the person that plays the quinto, the solo drum. Okay? Este sonido se usa mucho en la tradición de la rumba, cuando el que toca el quinto improvisa. Para tocar este sonido, los dedos aprietan aquí el cuero. Este dedo grande para afuera. El sonido está cerrado, cerrado. ¿Notas la diferencia? Abierto, cerrado. Notice the difference, open, closed, tapao. Those are six basic strokes that you need to know when we construct our tumbaos. Esos son seis movimientos que necesitas conocer para construir tumbaos, repetitive rhythms. Ahora, para practicar el tapao y el sonido de la palma. Now to practice the tapao and the palms. Very simple. You know that the tapaos are this. The sound of the drum closed off. Ya sabe que el tapao es esto. Apagando el tambor y la palma aquí. And the palms here. Okay? Very simple. So, let's do that alternating. Alternando. Very simple. Just get the movement down. Bien simple. Estamos practicando el movimiento. Of course, you can go faster when you get better. Obviamente, puedes ir más rápido cuando desarrollas la técnica. Very simple. Just go slow. Bien simple. Lento. Lento. Por favor, practica los sonidos. Practice the sounds, because once you have the sounds down, your sound will be beautiful when you play tumbaos. Después que tienes los sonidos controlados, los tumbaos van a sonar bellísimos. Ahora voy a tocar un tumbao en un tambor que es un poquito diferente que los otros tumbaos que tocamos. Este tumbao tiene una sincopación. What I'm going to do now is play a tumbao that's a little bit different. This has a slight syncopation to it. It's a two-bar pattern. Este patrón es de dos compases. Y okay, se puede utilizar para tocar varias formas de la música cubana cuando la melodía ocurre. This tumbao, you can utilize it in various forms of Cuban music to accompany the melody of the song. Now, I'm going to play it first and see if you can figure out, or from listening, where the clave lies. Voy a tocar primero. Vamos a ver si ustedes que están mirando el video pueden adivinar dónde cae la clave. One, two, three, four. Escucha el tumbao. Listen to the tumbao. See if you can figure out where the clave lies. Here I go. Okay. Si pensaste 2-3, esa fue la respuesta correcta. If you thought 2-3, that was the correct response. But you could have come in on the 3 side of the clave. Okay? También podías entrar en el lado 3 de la clave. Este es el tumbao empezando en el lado 3. This is the same tumbao starting on the 3 side of the clave. I'm going to do it slower so you can study the hand movement. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so that tumbao you can use in various styles of Cuban music for the melody, in all of the different styles of song. Puedes usar ese tumbao para acompañar la melodía en todas las formas del son cubano. Now, I'm going to show you a different tumbao. And here we utilize the bass tone. En este tumbao vamos a utilizar la palma para sacar esa nota gruesa, para sacar el tono bajo del tambor. We're going to get that bass tone out of the drum. But to get the bass tone out of the drum, we have to lift the drum, okay? Now, that's pretty difficult with this drum because it's new and it's all shiny and everything, so it's going to slip around a little bit. Hopefully, I'll be able to do it. Es un poquito difícil con este tambor. El tambor es nuevo y esto resbala un poco con los pantalones, pero vamos a tratar. And to do that, since you're not going to be able to hear me playing the clave, I'm going to invite my good friend from Japan, Masashi Tomikawa, to help me out playing clave. Masashi, how you doing, man?
Hey.
Good to see you. Okay. Mi gran amigo Masashi Tomikawa de Japón. Okay. Masashi happens to be my drum tech. Okay. Masashi es el técnico mío de batería y tambores. Okay. All right. Listen to the tumbao. Okay? I'm going to start it in the direction of 2-3. Okay? And we're going to use that bass tone with the pound, lifting the drum. Okay? Here we go. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so I lifted the drum a little bit and you got to hear a little bit of the bass tone. It's difficult lifting the drum, especially when the drum is new like this. Some people even use a belt around their waist to hold one of the lugs. Okay, escucharon el tono bajo en el tambor, levantando el tambor usando la palma. Es difícil levantar el tambor y alguna gente a veces usa una correa aguantando uno de estas llaves, uno de estos ganchos. Okay. But it's a very essential part of conga playing, and you should know how to do it and practice it. Okay? Es una técnica bien esencial en tocando la conga, y debe practicarlo. Now that you've gotten to practice a little bit on one conga drum, let's add another drum to keep time. Ya que has practicado tocando en una conga, vamos a adornar otra para tocar ritmos en dos. So we're using the conga and the tumbadora. These are the two main drums that we use to keep time when we play Cuban music in dance orchestras. La conga y la tumbadora son las dos congas principales que utilizamos para tocar tiempo en orquestas bailables que tocan ritmo cubano. Okay, now, remember that tumbao that I did for you before where I lifted the drum and played the bass tones here? We're going to use that same stroke pattern, but now we're going to utilize, instead of hitting the bass tones here, we're going to hit open tones here on this tumbadora. So you've already practiced the pattern. ¿Recuerdas ese patrón que tocamos con la palma de las manos, tocando las notas bajas esas? Vas a utilizar el mismo movimiento. En vez de tocar la palma aquí, vas a tocar tonos abiertos aquí en esta tumbadora. So you already know the pattern. Ya conoces el patrón. Vamos en la dirección 2-3. We're going in the direction 2-3. Here we go. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. Slower, más lento. 1, 2, 3, 4. Starting on the 3 side, empezando en el lado 3 de la clave. 1, 2, 3, 4. Fácil. Ya conoces el patrón, lo puedes hacer. Already you know the pattern, so you can do it right away. Now, to start off the pattern, you can give a strong feeling of a downbeat. Para empezar el patrón, puedes dar un sentido bien fuerte de la primera nota en la conga. Okay? You can do this by doing this. We're going to play an open tone right on beat one. Vamos a tocar un tono abierto en el primer golpe de la medida. Y después comenzamos con el patrón. Then we continue with the pattern. It's just to start off. Es solamente para comenzar, para estabilizar el tiempo. Listen to how we do it. Mira las manos. Watch my hands. Starting in 2-3. Empezando en 2-3. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. And we continue with the pattern. Seguimos con el ritmo. I'll do it one more time. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay? Vamos a hacerlo empezando en el lado 3 de la clave. Let's do it starting on the 3 side of the clave. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. Y seguimos el ritmo. That's just to establish a strong time feel right at the beginning. Eso es solamente para estabilizar el tiempo bien fuerte al principio. Okay, let's move on. Here's another type of tumbao that you can use to play. The same type of thing with two drums, but giving a feeling more of the ponche. Esta es la misma cosa, pero vamos a darle el sentido más al ponche de la clave. Remember what the ponche is, the last note of the three side of the clave. Recuerda que el ponche es la última nota del lado 3 de la clave. Okay, here we go in 2-3, in 2-3. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. In 3-2. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so you can utilize that also in playing the montuno section of Cuban music. These, when we use the two drums, it's usually in the montuno section. The montuno is just a rhythmic vamp, a series of chords, simple chord structure, and we use that in Cuban music to improvise. The word montuno comes from the word montura, the saddle of a horse. So we're actually riding on a saddle of chords. And we use the second drum to reinforce that. Okay? Ahora, para explicar más, utilizamos el segundo tambor cuando estamos en la sección que llamamos el montuno. El montuno es una serie de acordes que utilizamos en la música cubana para improvisar. Y usamos la tumbadora para ponerle más fuerza al montuno. La palabra montuno es bien interesante, viene de la palabra montura. Montura. Préstame tu caballo para ponerme mi montura. Ah, ok. You've probably heard that many times if you've listened to Cuban music. Si has escuchado la música cubana, has escuchado esa frase musical. It's what we call in Cuban music a cierre, a break. Eso es lo que llamamos en la música cubana un cierre, una frase común. Okay? Now, the concept of the cierre is very simple. It's a break, a rhythmical break that everybody plays together. The word cierre actually is derived from the word cerrado, which means closed off. So, the time stops, the timekeeping stops, and everybody plays this musical phrase, this rhythmic phrase together. La palabra cierre viene de la palabra cerrado. Y se cierra el tiempo, y todo el mundo toca este patrón o esta frase rítmicamente en unison. Okay, now, the cierres can be used in Cuban music in the structure of a song to create excitement for the dancers. El cierre se puede utilizar para excitar el ritmo para los bailadores en el arreglo de una pieza de música. It can also be used to change the direction of the clave. The clave isn't broken, but the cierre can be used if it's a certain amount of bars to come in on the other side of the clave. Podemos usar cierres también para cambiar la dirección de la clave. La clave no se rompe, pero la frase con los compases caen medidos y llegamos al otro lado de la clave. Okay, let me give you some common cierres that everybody that plays Cuban music knows. Dame unos cierres comunes que todo el mundo conoce. This first cierre that I did is called jicotea. Jicotea is the shell of a tortoise. I guess it refers in Cuban music like to the days when the timbala players used to play on tortoise shells in place of wood blocks. Este cierre se llama jicotea. Empieza en el lado dos de la clave. This starts on the two side of the clave. One, two, one, two, three, four. Okay, one more time. One, two, one, two, three, four. Okay, toqué el cierre dos veces. La segunda vez puse una ornamentación a la frase final. The second time I played the cierre, I added some extra notes just to ornament the break a little bit. Everybody knows the cierre that plays Cuban music, so you're going to hear it a lot when you start studying the music more and more. Here's another common cierre that's used in Cuban music. Starts on the two side. Otro cierre común. One, two, one, two, three, four. Otra vez. Okay, now I talked about how cierres can be used to switch the clave around. Hablé cómo se usan los cierres para cambiar la dirección de la clave. Un ejemplo de eso, an example of that. I'm going to play a little bit of time, and I'm going to count this common cierre in. Watch what happens. Listen to what happens. Escucha lo que pasa con la clave. Ah, 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 ah. One, two, one, two, three, four. See? Ya tú ves, estoy en el otro lado de la clave ahora. I'm on the other side of the clave. So listen for this when you're listening to Cuban music. Escucha para esto, escucha esto cuando estás escuchando la música cubana. You're going to be able to practice some of these cierres in some of the musical pieces that we do. Vas a practicar estos cierres comunes en algunas de las piezas musicales que tenemos más tarde en el video. Okay, now we're going to play a style of Cuban music known as guajira. It comes from the eastern region of Cuba, from the mountainous regions. The word guajira, literally translated, means a woman from the mountains, a peasant woman. Guajiro would be the male counterpart, but guajira is also a style of music. Ahora vamos a tocar una forma de música cubana que se llama guajira. Viene de la parte oriental de Cuba, la parte este en Cuba. Un guajiro es un hombre que trabaja en la montaña en la parte este de Cuba. Una guajira es una mujer, pero también la guajira es un ritmo. Ah, 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 ah. Oye mi guajira, lo bueno ya viene. Me fui. Vamos a bailar el son, mi guajira. Vamos a bailar el son. Vamos a bailar el son, mi guajira. Vamos a bailar el son. Oye, mi guajira, este rico son.
Sí, señor.
Que yo te canto de mi corazón.
¿Cómo no?
Oye, mi guajira, este rico son.
Señor,
que yo te canto de mi corazón.
¿Cómo no?
Nacido en la provincia de Oriente.
Sí, señor.
Donde la tierra está caliente.
¿Cómo no?
Nacido en la provincia de Oriente.
Sí, señor.
Donde la tierra es caliente.
¿Cómo no?
Recuerda las raíces, mi hermana. ¡Ah! De la música afrocubana. ¿A
qué rico el son.
Me fui.
Oye, qué rico el son.
¿Cómo te gusta el son, Guajira?
Now you're going to get a chance to play the guajira and the conga drum with Mario on the bass and John on the piano. Now you notice that the clave direction is 2-3, so you have to align your tumbaos with the clave, and at the end we have the a caballo section. In the beginning of the tune we have what we call aleteo, which means literally the flapping of a bird's wings. That's a little build-up that we use in Cuban music to introduce the song. Ahora ustedes van a tener un chance de tocar la guajira con Mario en el bajo y Jan en el piano. Notas que en el principio de la canción la clave está estabilizada, es en 2-3. So, tiene que alinear los tumbaos con la dirección de la clave. También tenemos algo que llamamos en la música cubana aleteo, esas notas que usamos para subir el ritmo e introducir la canción. Ok, here we go. ¡A gozar con la rica guajira! ¡Ah! ¡Ah! Ah, 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 ah.
Óyeme, guajira, lo bueno ya viene. ¡Anda! ¡Rico! ¡Ahí nada más!
Ah, vamos a bailar el son, mi guajira. Vamos a bailar el son. Vamos a bailar el son, mi guajira. Vamos a bailar el son.
¡Ahí nada más! Oye, mi guajira, este rico son.
Sí, señor,
yo te canto de mi corazón.
¿Cómo no?
Oye, mi guajira, este rico son.
Sí, señor,
que yo te canto de mi corazón.
¿Cómo no?
Nacido en la provincia de Oriente.
Sí, señor,
donde la tierra es caliente.
¿Cómo no?
Nacido en la provincia de Oriente.
Sí, señor,
donde la tierra está caliente. ¡Ahí nada más! Recuerda las raíces, mi hermana. ¡Ahí!
De la música afrocubana.
¡Ah!
Vamos a bailar el son. Vamos a bailar el son, mi guajira. Vamos a bailar el son. Vamos a bailar el son, mi guajira. Vamos a bailar el son.
¡A caballo! ¡Ahí, mi guajira! ¡Me voy a caballo! ¡A monte adentro!
Son guajira, ahí nada más. We're going to play for you a popular style of Cuban music now, Son Montuno, popularized by Arsenio Rodriguez, a great blind guitarist and tres player from the 1930s. In fact, because of him, we use the conga drums in dance bands today. Ahora vamos a tocar una forma del son, el Son Montuno, muy popular, se popularizó por el gran tresista y guitarrista Arsenio Rodríguez en los años 30. Fue por Arsenio que estamos usando las congas hoy en día en las bandas bailables. Ok, here we go. Ah, 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 ah.
El rico Son Montuno. Número uno. Me voy con el cierre. Ah, 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 ah. La gente pide para bailar.
gozar.
El sol nació en Oriente,
a bailar
en la ciudad de Baracoa,
a gozar
con Micaela y Teodora,
a bailar
que llegaban a Baracoa,
a gozar
de la República Dominicana,
a bailar
empezaron a componer,
a bailar
el son de la mata Teodora,
a bailar
y ahora todo el mundo goza. El son montuno. La gente pide para bailar. El son montuno. ¡Juega, Juancito!
Now it's your turn to play along to the son montuno. Ahora ustedes van a tocar el rico son montuno.
El rico son montuno, el ritmo número uno. Ciudad de Baracoa,
pa' gozar.
El sol nació en Oriente,
pa' bailar.
En la ciudad de Baracoa,
pa' gozar.
Cuando Micaela y Teodora,
pa' bailar,
llegaron a Baracoa,
pa' gozar.
De la República Dominicana,
pa' bailar,
empezaron a componer,
pa' gozar.
El son de la mata Teodora, y ahora todo el mundo goza. ¡Ahí!
Vamos a bailar. La gente pide para bailar el son montuno.
La gente pide para bailar el son montuno. ¡Camina, Juancito! ¡Ripi! ¡Tin, ti, ti!
The mambo is a music that became very, very popular in the 1940s. The word actually is a Bantu Congolese word. It means a chant or song that repeats over and over again.
La palabra mambo significa algo, una canción que diga que se repite. ¿Okay? Es una palabra de origen bantu congolés, la gente de Zaire, un tribu de gente en Zaire, de donde viene este instrumento, la conga. ¿Okay? The mambo is very, very jazz oriented, since it fused with jazz in the 1940s here in New York City. El mambo se combinó con el jazz afroamericano aquí en Nueva York.
Recordando a Antonio Arcaño, Arsenio Rodríguez, Orestes López, Cachao y Pérez Prado, los creadores del mambo, ahí nada más.
Okay, remember when you play along to the mambo that you're using two open tones. The mambo has a very, very driving sound. It's not like the other forms of song that we played before, the guajira, the son montuno, the guaracha, where sometimes we hit the ponche with the tumbaos. The mambo tumbao is very, very driving and always has two open tones. Recuerden que en el tumbao del mambo siempre hay dos golpes abiertos en la conga, porque el sonido es bien pa'lante. Here we go.
Recordando al señor Antonio Arcaño, Orestes López, Cachao y Damaso Pérez Prado, los creadores del rico mambo. ¡Anda! Mambo, mambo, óyelo, qué rico el mambo, mambo, óyelo, qué rico el mambo, mambo.
ya, mambo, que ya me voy, mulata, mambo, el rico mambo ya, mambo, los tiempos del paledío, mambo, el mambo con jazz, mulata, mambo, me fui, mambo.
Bueno, ahora vamos a coger el ritmo de mambo, pero más lento. Now we're going to take the mambo a little bit slower in case you were having trouble keeping up with that fast tempo. Here we go.
Ahí nada más me fui con el ponche. El mambo, óyelo, qué rico el mambo, mambo, óyelo, qué rico el mambo, mambo, óyelo, qué rico el mambo, mambo.
Okay, we hope you've enjoyed Fundamento 1. Take your time, go back, review the tape. Everything comes with patience, and of course, the conga is a very physical instrument, so if your hands hurt at first, take your time. Now on Fundamento 2, we're going to cover additional rhythms on two conga drums and more of the song tradition. We're also going to cover a little bit on the rumba tradition. The rumba has a different type of clave, a different type of feel, because it's a different type of music. And also, you're going to get more chances to play along with John and Mario on piano and bass, practicing along with them. And in addition, we have one of the greatest congueros in the history of the music, the legendary Candido Camero from Cuba, performing for you, and we'll also do an interview segment with him so he can tell you about some of the innovations he developed on multiple conga drumming. Bueno, hemos terminado con Fundamento 1. Coge la cosa con paciencia. En el principio todo es difícil, pero con paciencia todo viene. Yo sé que las manos, por ejemplo, te van a doler en el principio, pero coge paciencia. Este instrumento es bien físico. Ahora, en Fundamento 2, vamos a seguir en la meta, estudiando más de la tradición del son y combinaciones con dos congas tocando en la tradición del son. También vamos a tocar un poco de la música que llamamos rumba. La rumba tiene su propia clave, es una música diferente que el son. Y además, vamos a tener una pequeña entrevista con una de las grandes leyendas de la música afrocubana, de la percusión afrocubana, el gran Candido Camero, la primera persona que tocó dos y tres congas. So lo vemos en Fundamento 2. We'll see you on Fundamento Volume 2.